Hi friends, today we are going to see demo on task overview and song. If you have not seen my recent blog on getting started with Snowflake task, I would suggest you to please have a look. I have provided blog link in the YouTube video description. Hope you will like this demo. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not done yet for upcoming interesting demo. Let's start with the demo. So I'm connected to my Snowflake database, sorry, and today I'm going to showcase you three different scenarios, and that will clear up your basic idea about the task, what is task, and how we can use task in Snowflake. So for this demo, I'm going to use the role sysadmin. I'm going to create a new database called task demo, and I'm going to create table then job tracker. So let's start. So I have just created a task demo database. You can see it's blank, and I'm using the public schema. So let's use the public schema, and I'm going to create a table called job tracker. So this table will contain the job name, job time, remarks, and job state. Throughout my demo, I'm going to use this table to populate it using task. So let's create the table. Let's refresh. You can see that in the public schema, we can see the job tracker table. So the first scenario is like I'm going to create a simple task to insert a record in the table every minute. So that's a very simple and very basic concept of task. So we can schedule either a simple SQL statement or a procedure using task. We can't schedule anything else in Snowflake as of now. So there is only two options to support, SQL or procedure. So in this demo, I'm going to use only SQL statement with different varieties and different scenarios. So for first task, I'm going to create a replace task name. I'm going to provide the warehouse or which computer I'm going to use. What is the schedule, whether it's permanent or it's different, whether I want to use a cron tab style, like that we need to provide so that the task understand that at what interval he has to execute the given statement. So here in this task, I'm just providing my warehouse, compute warehouse, and I'm scheduling that it should run at every 1 minute, and I'm going to provide an insert statement to insert into job tracker table with the default value of task one, and with the increments, like with the current timestamp, and a remarks called task one remarks and the status called active. So let's create this task. So one thing we need to keep in mind that whenever we create a task, the task will get created in a suspended mode. So it will not be in activated mode or started mode by default. To do that, you have to either switch to account admin and resume the task, or you should have the privilege to execute the task. So let me create the task. And then let me show you what is the status of current task. So if I execute show task will help you to list down the task and the current status of that task. So you can see that the task one is created under database name task demo, schema name public, and owner is sysadmin, and warehouse detail and schedule are all given, but the state is under suspended. So to execute this, I'm not going to give the rules and all. I'm going to use simple. I'm going to switch my role to account admin, and I'm going to give the execute task on account to sysadmin. And then we can just switch our role to sysadmin, and then we can alter the task to resume. Either I can also execute the same statement using the account admin role, but because I have already given the grant, I can use that using the sysadmin role. So now currently I'm on sysadmin role, and let me show the task again. You can see that the state is now started. Let's execute this and see. So we have to wait for a minute, because we have scheduled it for every minute. So by that time it will get execute in a 1 minute. Let's explain another part. Like if you want to suspend, so you have to use the alter task name suspend. So in that way you can suspend the task and then the task will be no more running on the background. So if you keep your task running, you will keep on executing or utilizing your compute, and it's keep on costing you. So always keep in mind, if you are not needing the task or the functionality inside the task to be running, please suspend the task, else you will get charged, because it will keep on running on the interval you have decided and it will cost you. So let's see whether we see the data here. So we can see that by now 1 minute has passed and the first record has been populated into the table. So we can see there is one record. So now that we have seen already, that the simple scenario one, we can suspend the task because we don't need this task anymore as of now. I'm not dropping, I'm just suspending because I'm going to use the same task in future in the scenario two. But I'm going to truncate the table so that I can start fresh. So now the table is truncated, there is nothing inside the table. Now scenario two. So in scenario two, I'm going to create a simple tree of tasks. So it's not a single task. I'm going to create a root task, and then I am going to create a couple of child tasks. Each task is dependent on their parent predecessor task, or you can say the parent task for that child task. So in that scenario, I'm going to use task one, which I created on scenario one, as a root task. And all the task two and task three, which I am going to create in scenario two, is going to follow in a particular fashion. So I'm going to put a new statement known as after task one. Basically, when I create a new task, I'm not going to provide the schedule for this child task. Rather, I would say after task one or after task name, whichever task you want to mention as a parent for this task. So here I am want to use task one as a root task, and I'm going to provide as after task one as, and then I'm going to provide the statement which I am going to execute. So for here, I'm just provide the same insert statement. The only difference is I'm populating that with a different name as task two, and I have modified the remarks with task two remarks. Rest all the things are same. Similarly, for the task three, I provided task two as a parent task, and then I am modifying the same value over here. So let's execute this and create two different tasks. And let's see, now by now we should have three tasks in the show task list. So you can see task one, task two, and task three. And you can also see that here the parent task is mentioned over here. And if I execute, yes. So now you can see that for task one, there is no parent task because that's itself is a root task. For task two, task one is parent. For task three, task two is parent. But all are suspended because we have just created task two and task three, and task was manually put into suspended mode by me as part of scenario two cleanup. So now that we have already created a task and we already have the privilege to enable that, all the tasks, I'm just wanted to show you another way how we can use that. So say if you have multiple ta child tasks for a parent task, rather than going and enabling each and every child task and the parent task manually, you can use this statement select system. You can use this function system dollar task dependent enable, and you have to provide the parent task name. So the moment you will execute this, it will enable the root task as well as all the child tasks at the one go. So you don't have to execute each and every task, child task manually. This saves time and this is more logical. So I'm going to execute this. So yep, so you can see now it's return me, the function return me okay message. Now let's go and execute the show task. Now you can see that all the tasks per root and the child task has started. So let's go and execute the table and see whether we see any data. No, we don't see data, but by the time we pass 1 minute, we will see one record, and then subsequently we will see another second and third record based on task one, task two, and task three. So let's wait for some time. So but So we'll see how much time it takes. So okay, by the time we will go. So after this, we will also suspend both all the three tasks. For suspending a task, there is no similar function that we provide the root task and it will suspend all the child tasks. For suspending, we have to use individual suspend statement. So let's see if we have see we got the data over here. No, we still don't see any data over here. Now we see that first record, the root task has executed, and we see that job time, task one. So let's execute again and see whether second record came. Yeah, now we see that task two, because task two are dependent on task one. The moment task one completed, task two started. So you can see the difference of few seconds. Now if I execute, I will see the third record as well. So now you can see the third record as well. So you can see there are a couple of seconds difference, but you see that task one run first, then task two because it was dependent on task one, and then task three because it was dependent on task two. So if we keep this on running, we will see another set of three record. But as we have already seen, I don't want you to showcase that part. So I'm just going to suspend all the tasks. And now let's switch again and see whether we all the tasks has been suspended or not. So we can see all the tasks has been suspended. So that's scenario two, how you can create a root task and a child task, and how you can execute based on the dependency on a hierarchy. So now let's go and see the third scenario, where I am going to use different method of scheduling. I'm not going to schedule for per minute, rather I want to schedule for a particular date or a pattern, right? So in that scenario, I'm going to use the using cron tab type or the cron job type or the style of scheduling. Here the only difference in the schedule parameter is I'm going to provide like using cron, and then I have five different ways where you can provide the parameters, like the first start for the minute, then for hours, then for day, then for week, and then for the month, and then the time zone. So let's see first what is the UTC time zone for now. So let's refresh this. So we can see it's 21:14. I wanted to schedule it for second. So let me do one thing. Let me truncate the job tracker table first so that we don't get confused. So I'm going to I have truncated the job tracker table, and now I am going to schedule it for say 15, 21, 15, 21, and then 15. And I'm going to use the same simple statement, and I'm going to resume the, sorry, I have to resume, right? To resume, I have to use the where is the statement? I forgot to create. Okay, I'm going to use the same. So now that I have created, I can see that task cron job has been created. Sorry, I have used the wrong one, and I have to suspend that all the task. Alright, I have to use this cron job name with the enable name. So let me enable the yes, I have to use the this one, alter task and then resume. I forgot to create the statement, but I can. So before starting the job, let me see if we see any data. No, there is no data. Let me start the job. And let me see that whether we see any kind of issue with the task. So I can see that all other are suspended and this one is started. So I'm assuming within 11:15 it should get executed. So it already started. I'm not sure if we missed the time, but 16 already. Let me do one thing. Let me schedule it for 17 so that we can see again. So let me suspend this task because I'm not sure it will get executed or not. Let me recreate this cron job. Sorry, So let me see what is the time. Let me create it for 18 and execute this. So cron job is created. Let me resume this and then let's see the task. So we can see now it's started, and let's wait for 1918. So the moment we will see here the 1918, this job will get executed. So let's wait for some time. Let me pause the video, and by the time we will see 18, we will see one record. So let's see before pausing that do we see any data into the table. So let's execute this statement and see. We don't see any data. Let's pause for a moment and then we will. So now we can see that we have already reached to the scheduled time. Let's go back. So now we see that at the time it get executed when the time came as per the schedule. We see that the record got executed. So this is the time which is local to my time zone, but we have scheduled based on UTC. So we have seen the moment we see at the UTC time zone is reached to the scheduled time, that is 9:18, our task executed and inserted the record into the table. So that's how you can use varieties, whether you can schedule for every 1 minute, 5 minute as a frequency, or you can schedule for a particular date, month, day. So there are different varieties. So you can go into the Snowflake documentation and there you can see the other varieties of how you can schedule using the cron tab, or you can also see detail on my blog. I have provided those details. So now that we have seen that record has been inserted, so it will again get executed when the time reaches the same 9:18. So it will not execute today anymore. So now that we have seen everything, I don't need this setup. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to disable both the job. So I'm going to disable this job. Let's disable or suspend this job. And now I'm going to drop or clean up everything because this demo is done. I don't need this, any of these things. So I'm going to drop all the tasks and I'm going to drop the database so that I'm not getting charged for anything extra. So that's how we have seen that we can use task for creating a simple task, or we can create a tree of tasks, or we can also schedule a task in a different manner using cron job style, or we can also schedule as per frequency. Hope you like my video, and if yes, you can subscribe to my channel and like my video. Thank you.